Welcome into Sports Memo's Betting Podcast, NHL edition. We're looking at the Tuesday card here, but it's February 24th, and we're talking with Andrew McInnis, our NHL betting expert from north of the border. Welcome in. How are you doing today, Andrew?
Hey, Drew. It's been a great day. The trade deadline expired today. So, I mean, every team in the NHL had their last bit of chances to make a little bit of make some moves and try and shape their team the best way they can to make a good run in the playoffs. So it's always fun. It's always fun to track the moves, whether it's a minor move, a big move, see who went where. It's enjoyable. From a betting standpoint, though, you get to kind of figure out how different teams are going to be priced, so on and so forth with their new team members and stuff like that. So looking forward to the next week or two to see how some of these new pieces help out their teams.
Absolutely. Is there anything you want to throw out there in terms of, I guess the trade deadline was just like an hour or two ago. So I know you don't have a lot of time to break it down and come up with like philosophies going forward, but anything you wanted to throw out there that you think kind of new bettors to the NHL need to know about?
I would say you got to be careful of which teams you want to instantly bet on and which teams you should actually be careful with. And that's about chemistry. I think for a team, let's say like Pittsburgh, they just acquired Connor Sheary, a player that was actually on that team in 2015 when they won the Stanley Cup. They got him back, brought him back to their team. They got a guy in Patrick Marleau from the San Jose Sharks. He's a veteran in the league, a guy that's been in the league for a long time. I wouldn't really worry too much about chemistry with those guys. So Pittsburgh, to me, is a bet-on situation. But certain teams you might want to be a little bit cautious with, you know, with some newer, younger guys, like stuff like that, going towards a team. Maybe they might take a little bit of time to settle in with their new club. But, you know, a lot of teams making some moves. The Edmonton Oilers, a big team I wanted to mention, West Coast Canadian team. Man, are they fast. I mean, they already have the fastest player in the world in Connor McDavid. Just got back from his injury last night, scored a highlight reel goal. And now they're picking up so many all-star players. It's unbelievable, the guys they got. They got so a player, I can't even really pronounce his name, Asteniseu, I think his name is, and Tyler Ennis, two guys that are absolutely going to tear it up for them on the second and third line. Drew, for me, in the trade deadline, it's not just about picking up an all-star. It's about picking up that third line guy that's going to slot right in and contribute. You know, you talk about it in the NBA, how you have the big three. I think in the NHL these days, you have to have the big three lines. You can't just have one top line that scores for you. The Bruins, for example, they picked up a guy that's going to be more of a tough guy for them, Adam Ritchie. And I think that he's someone that they might have needed because they got a little softer recently. So they add more toughness. They already have the skill. So much to talk about. I'm obviously, as you can tell, I'm pretty excited about it. And it kind of just shapes up for a brand new league in the second half of the season, man.
Yeah, cool. Excited to get some more thoughts in terms of betting strategies with the trade deadline. Guys, we got four games we're going to be breaking down, plus a best bet for the podcast. Again, this is Tuesday, February 25th, NHL betting card we're going to be breaking down. We're looking at this from Monday night right now, so the numbers may shift just a little bit, but let's start off top of the card here. Love these rotation numbers in the NHL, McInnis. We got game number one. Game number two here, the rotation numbers. Calgary at Boston. Looks like the Bruins, minus 210 to minus 220, depending where you're shopping right now. And a total of six. So heavy favorites here at home for the Bruins.
Yeah, Drew, I actually had an over 5.5 wager on this Boston Bruins-Calgary Flames matchup when it was out in the West Coast, when the Bruins were on their West Coast road trip just over on the weekend. So this is kind of a rapid revenge spot here. One of those kind of looks because it was a 4-3 victory for the Bruins. The Bruins came out on top against Calgary, and it was a fast-paced game from top to bottom, from start to finish. And I don't really see any difference in that in this one here moving forwards. I'm looking at the first period over, and I'm looking at the full game over. And that's kind of a trend that you might not want to look at if you're the Boston Bruins, if you're backing them right now, because they have actually been trending completely under in the first period. But a theory that I've been running with, Drew, and this kind of goes along with the same thing as my West Coast road trip theory, is that the first game back, I'm not looking to bet on this team. I'm not looking to kind of, you know, bet on them to play a great defensive game. The Bruins usually play so well at TD Garden, but I expect them to take a little bit of time to settle in and get things together. You know, they just played in Vancouver, and it was a long road trip for them. You know, Edmonton, Calgary, Vancouver. I think they played 3 games in 4 days. They went 2-1 on those and those in that road trip. But Drew, they ended their road trip losing 9-3, and that's actually the game I had my 5% play on the over in. And I think some of that will carry into this game here. You know, they need some time back at home to relax and get things together. And Calgary, you know, they've been involved in a lot of high scoring games recently. I'm talking about an 8-4 loss, a 6-4 win, stuff like that is what's happening to the Calgary Flames right now. And right now you can get it at around plus $1.05 on the over 6 in this game.
All right, nice stuff. First game down here. We got game number 11, game number 12 up next. Battle for New York. Another 7 o'clock Eastern puck drop here. New York Rangers, New York Islanders. Islanders, the home team here, minus 135. Total of 6 here, McInnis.
So this is kind of the first little breakdown we'll see that involves the trade deadline. The New York Islanders picked up Jean-Gabriel Pageau. They definitely kind of wanted to add a little bit more scoring. Nothing too crazy. Very, very sneaky player, small player, Quebec guy. Someone that's not going to really stand off the score sheet by any means, but he's someone that's going to get the job done for you. And this will be his first game in a New York Islander uniform. So I think that that's kind of going to be a factor. I mean, this is one of those chances where I was saying that you don't want to bet on every team that acquired somebody new. But this is one of those teams, Drew, that you're going to want to do that. I mean, they were struggling offensively for a little while, and they've always been a good defensive team. They already have guys like Jordan Eberle, Matthew Barzal. But now to add a guy like Pageau to just be another goal scorer for them, I think it's very crucial. But another point I wanted to add about this, and this is something that I literally learned today. There's pretty much been 3 goalies on the New York Rangers lately. It's been Henrik Lundqvist, Georgiev, and Shesterkin. And pretty much Henrik Lundqvist is a veteran goalie in the league, and he's actually been getting healthy scratched a little bit. He's been up in the rafters. It's mostly just been Shesterkin or Georgiev. And they were actually both involved in a car accident, a very minor car accident today. And it looks like Shesterkin got the heavy, you know, part of it. I think he had a fractured rib, something like that. This is a guy that's a rookie, Drew, posting an 8-1 record on the season. He's been dominant, nothing but dominant. I've been betting on the Rangers whenever he's been involved, and I've been betting on the under. And now that he's injured, I feel like it'll really hurt this team. I mean, they've been living and dying by him, and they've been giving up goals when he hasn't been in the net. And they also, this Rangers team, decided that they kind of wanted to go for it here. And when I say go for it, they decided they didn't really want to be sellers at the deadline. Instead of trading away Chris Kreider, who is actually an unrestricted free agent, they decided to sign him to a 7-year contract. So pretty much for the past 3 to 4 weeks, everybody thought that Chris Kreider was one of the most talked about free agents. And all of a sudden, instead of deciding to sell him off for draft picks or for other pieces, they go ahead and sign him for seven years. So, you know, that's the only bright spot right now for the Rangers. But I feel like they made a mistake. They should have sold him away and built their team a little bit more. And now that Shesterkin's injured, I feel like it's a really bad spot. At home, I'm really comfortable here taking the Islanders in the money line at minus 135. And I would really make sure you're looking at these numbers and making sure you're getting the proper numbers, because we're already starting to see some minus 140s pop up. And I feel like a lot of people are going to like the Islanders tomorrow.
He's Andrew McInnis from north of the border, knows his NHL as good as anybody out there. Guys, he's hit 8 straight NHL 5% top plays. He's up big in terms of percent of return on investment here for the season. We also got his CFL season right around the corner. So good time to be on McInnis's service. And guys, we got a 48-hour special here till Tuesday night at midnight. Coupon code AM999 at checkout will take $1,000 off his 1-year all-access package. That's 365 days of service here in every sport where McInnis releases a play. So all of the NHL, any NFL down the stretch, the whole year here you'll get for $1,000 off. Coupon code AM999 at checkout. For Andrew McInnis, coupon code AM999 at checkout. Sports Memo NHLPicks.com. We got two games left and the best bet here, McInnis. But did want to, I mean, I know you kind of, we opened it up here with betting strategies, you know, post All-Star break, but did want to give you the platform in terms of, are there any particular betting strategies you use from, I guess, tonight's action, just one game, really tomorrow's action, talking Tuesday night here, going forward to the Stanley Cup in terms of, we got change as a sports bettor, you know, finding change is always a big thing, but in terms of just specifically to hockey strategies you use?
I think that, first of all, first and foremost, the biggest thing is looking at the right price. You want to make sure that you're betting a team at the proper price that they should be at. And betting against the team at maybe a reasonable number. And I would say, first of all, you want to fade the sellers. Fade the sellers early, not later. And when I say that, I mean fade the teams that just traded away the bulk of their players for draft picks, because they have made it very evident to us as bettors and the media and the rest of the league that they have zero interest in winning for the rest of the year. They are playing for draft picks. And sometimes those teams start to win a little bit more in the later half of the season. Just kind of, they're playing spoiler. They got a couple of guys called up from the minors that are trying to make a name for themselves. But as for right now, I would fade those guys. And I know this podcast, Drew, is going to be shown mostly for people on the Tuesday card, and people watching on Tuesday. But I want to just say this. Tonight, on a Monday, we have Columbus and Ottawa. It's the only game of the night. And I faded the Ottawa Senators for that exact reason. You know, people watching tomorrow are going to be able to know the result, whether I won or not. But you want to fade those teams that have clearly made it evident that they're not going to, you know, be contenders this year. Number two, I'd say you want to back the teams that gathered some secondary scoring. So don't back the teams that just went ahead and got that one big guy. Go ahead and back those teams that got a couple, you know, sneaky, shifty players that you might not think are household names, but are going to slot in just perfectly with their teams. Those are the difference between the hockey fans and the people that actually know that that guy was a seventh round pick, but should have been a third round pick. And that's the difference to me with the trade deadline. It's not about the big names. It's about how somebody fits with a certain team. And again, a massive shout out to Jim Rutherford. He is the general manager for the Pittsburgh Penguins. In my opinion, Drew, this guy is the best general manager in hockey. He doesn't ever go after just the big guns. He always finds the right players to slot right into the perfect position. And over the past three and a half weeks, he's definitely done that and done a great job. Same with Talon with the Edmonton Oilers. Done a great job there of building that team.
Good stuff, McInnis. Post-trade deadline betting strategies there. Two games left here. And then the best bet from McInnis. And guys, rest of his NHL season, 1 year all access package here, AM999 at checkout is the coupon code. SportsMemo.com includes football, baseball. You're doing some spring training too, huh, McInnis?
nothing too crazy, but 3-0 so far, picking my spots, trying to get some plus money. Caught the Jays at plus 150 on the weekend. Looking at some lineups, Drew, nothing too crazy, but like I said, sometimes you can go out there and look, hey, look, these are all, you know, nine names that I have no idea who these guys are. I'm going to fade this lineup. And sometimes you can go out there, like the Baltimore Orioles, they suited up a lineup that was pretty much a complete major league lineup the other day. And I thought it was against the rules to have so many guys that were MLB guys. But, you know, we'll have some MLB action. I'm a little bit lower volume in it, but I follow it on a day-to-day basis. We'll also have tennis going in the summer, which is kind of a new thing I've been following for the past 2 years. And last summer, that's kind of what I coincided with CFL. It was CFL on the weekends and tennis during the week.
All right. Well, check it out, guys. It's all included in the 1 year all access package, sportsmemo.com. Andrew McInnis's page there. He's hot right now in the NHL. Good time to jump on. Coupon code AM999 at checkout. $1,000 off his 1 year all access package. Let's finish it out here, McInnis. We got game number 19-20 here, Chicago at St. Louis. The Blues, heavy favorites here, minus $2, minus $200 at home, 5.5 the total, but there is pretty heavy juice on the over.
Yeah, that's where I'm going, Drew, is with the over. I think there's heavy juice on it for a good reason. I'm shocked that you can get a 5.5 with this here. I'm talking about Bet Online is where I see it, minus 115, 120. I'm sure at numerous places you can get the 5.5, but Five straight meetings between these two teams in St. Louis have gone over the total. We saw Chicago during the trade deadline trade away Robin Leonard to the Vegas Golden Knights. So now it's just Corey Crawford remaining as the goaltender here. And he hasn't been impressive to me at all. He hasn't done anything too special. So I look to see a lot of overs for the rest of the season with Chicago. They don't get me wrong. They still do have some goal scorers that will score for them. And St. Louis, they don't really deserve any pats on the back themselves as far as, you know, on a larger scale this season, keeping the total under. I think that with the 5.5 total, we've seen a decent amount of overs with them. Recently, they've really been buckling down, though. But their scoring has picked up. 4 goals against Minnesota, 5 goals against Dallas. I feel like with just the 5.5 goal total, we'll see an over here tomorrow. Unless St. Louis completely shuts the door. But I can see Chicago being one of those spoiler teams that although they're not going to go to the playoffs, they're going to still compete against some of the best teams in the league.
We got one game left here, guys. The nightcap, 10 o'clock Eastern puck drop here on the West Coast. Edmonton, the Edmonton Oilers at the Anaheim Mighty Ducks. Looks like 5.5 or 6 being the total with Edmonton. The road favorite here, McInnis, -145 to -150 in Anaheim.
Yeah, this is one of those spots here where I got to back this team. That Anaheim proved that they were a seller. Edmonton, part of my handicapping, Drew, is a lot of it what I do is I watch interviews from coaches, players, management, and I can really get the vibe of what they're playing, what they're saying, how their practices are going, what their goal is for the season, what their goal is for the next week, what their goal is for the next game. And this management sounds so confident in this team. They went through so much of a tough time over the past, I'd say, 5 years with this team. They were able to pick up so many number one draft picks, first round draft picks. Now they have Connor McDavid, arguably one of the better players in the world, if not the best player in the world. They have Athanasiou now with Connor McDavid on their line mates, Draisaitl, Nugent Hopkins, all these guys. It's so helpful for them. I mean, there was a stat, Drew, I think it was 66% of all goals for the first half of the season or for the first few months of the season came from two players, either an assist or a goal, those two guys scoring. It was McDavid or Draisaitl. Imagine that, whether it's an assist or a goal, 66% of goals scored by Edmonton were either assisted or scored by two players. So they knew that they had to get some more scoring. That's exactly what they did. By picking up Tyler Ennis and picking up Athanasiou. And I think that, you know, this is a guy, clearly a hard name to pronounce, but coming from Detroit, which is one of the worst teams I've seen in my lifetime, they aren't even going to reach 20 wins in the season. And now he gets traded to a playoff contending team, going to be on the first line. You'd think he'd be motivated. I think he'll slot right in. And this is a very generous price, in my opinion here, Drew. And a lot of times we talk about value. People will say, you know, what's the highest price you'll go to? You know, I would take this at -150 if it was there. I think it's good enough price. So I think Edmonton gets the job done.
He's 42% return on investment this year alone in the NHL. He's hit 8 straight NHL 5% top plays. Check him out, sportsmemo.com. His one-year all-access package till 12 o'clock midnight Tuesday night. Discounted $1,000 with the coupon code AM999 at checkout. As in Andrew McInnis, AM999 at checkout. So McInnis, best bet time, man. Where are we going? With the best bets, by the way.
Best bet. We're going into New York. We're going to New York for this one. It's going to be the Islanders. They're going to take on the Rangers and get the job done at $1.35. Better team. They're going in a better direction. The Rangers think they have a hope to push towards the playoffs. I don't think they do whatsoever. I think the Islanders get the job done. Best bet material for us, Tuesday night action.
All right, got to pull up my app here and put that in. New York Islanders -134 right now. Looks to be the low watermark. So good stuff in the battle for New York. Good podcast overall, McInnis. We got the coupon code AM999 at checkout. His one-year all-access package hot right now in the NHL. Good in CFL as well right around the corner. And, of course, it includes every play he releases in every sport. So, McInnis, anything else you want to throw out here before we shut this down?
We're good to go, Drew. For everybody out there watching, give me a follow on Twitter at McInnis Picks, McInnis. Of course, Drew at Drew Martin Bets. And I've been tweeting out some live plays. Last night, I gave out 3 live winners in the NHL. Most of them are total bets, but getting the job done, that's some free plays in play as well. So check me out during the game sometimes, and I'll try and tweet out some picks.
Good stuff, McInnis on Twitter at McInnis Picks, on Twitter at Drew Martin Bets. Guys, best of luck with your bets. We'll be back tomorrow talking XFL with Robbie Vino. Best of luck with your bets, guys.